Okay. So this process is called dissolution. Fine. This video is continued from the last video. Fine. So this process is called dissolution. Now, an amazing thing about it is not a one-way process. Okay? So it is not that only the solute molecules are moving into the solvent. What happens? Some of those solute molecules which have got dissolved into the solvent, they also keep on bumping out of it. They keep on coming out of it and become a solid back. Okay? This process is known as crystallization. Okay? This is the process of crystallization. So, also the solute molecules keep on coming out of the solvent and become solid. This process is called crystallization. This process is called crystallization. No, see, this is kind of this, you know, it's kind of diffusion kind of thing that keeps on happening. It's not a one-way movement. For example, you burn an incense stick at this point of the room, this corner of room, what happens? It'll keep on moving the molecules of the incense stick, which are perfumed, they will move to the other part. Why? Because the concentration here is more than the concentration there. But you cannot restrict the air molecules from those part coming into this part. What happens is that there is a constant bombarding by the liquid molecules onto the solid molecules which have gone into the liquid. So for example, what is happening? There is a solute molecule here. Now this has got dissolved, this has got kind of, it is surrounded by solute molecules. That is when you say that it has become aqueous. That is when you say that it has completely dissolved, right? Now what happens, say that you have this sugar cube out here, okay? Now what happens? So some of the molecules, they are being bombarded by the liquid, okay? And the sugar molecules, they keep on coming out. Let us say the green ones are sugar molecules, let us say the green ones. So I'll show this cube in green. Okay, and so this green molecule has gone out. This is also a green molecule. So this is a sugar molecule. Now what happens? It may so happen that a liquid hits it and this kind of travels back to this place. You understand? This comes back. It is not essential. Now you'll say, what if I dissolve the whole of sugar molecules? Still, it may so happen that 2 or 3 or 7 or 10 of the salts of the sugar molecules, okay, C6H12O6, say glucose molecules, they come and coalesce together. Okay, so what is happening? They are trying to reform the solid from which they have come. Okay, and the moment maybe they form a solid, another liquid comes and breaks them, say, into 7 and 3. And say another one deposits two more. So this is a dynamic process. This is not a...
Why do we get the sugar cube back?
No, because the entropy has gone up. You won't be able to... See, getting sugar cube back in the same form.
Not the same form, like exact amount of sugar that we put in.
No.
Why can't we get that back?
That is not possible. Why is it not? The same amount is not possible. The process of diffusion, you know. You cannot get it back. Yes, there are ways in which you can get back. You start reducing the temperature. It ejects out.
All of it.
No, not all of it, but a lot of it comes out. So if you have honey put in your refrigerator or maybe in winter season even outside, you'll find a lot of crystallization occurring at the bottom of the bottle. So it'll be all sugary. If you should take it out and try to eat it, it is all sugar. It actually makes a crunchy sound under your teeth. It's all sugar that has been ejected out. So yes, by reducing the temperature, you put it in a freezer, more of the sugar will come out. And then you kind of remove that sugar, fine. And then again put it, more will get ejected out as you obviously keep on reducing the temperature. It is dependent on temperature. That is important.
So if we take the sugar out,
then some more will come out.
Like that, we can take out all the sugar.
No, all will not come out. You know, for that you'll have to go to 0K. But a lot of it can be gotten back. Okay. So this process is called crystallization. Now what happens? The dissolution and crystallization, they keep on taking place. Okay? So if you have say two tablespoonful of sugar dissolved in say a glass of water, then this keeps on happening. Okay? You obviously won't be able to see it because maybe it forms a small crystal and then it gets dissolved. But this is a dynamic process that you have to understand. And at any steady state, when do you say that a steady state has reached? The steady state is said to have reached when the rate of dissolution is equal to the rate of crystallization. So hope you have written this. So it's an equilibrium state. At any given point of time, the rate of dissolution if we have reached the steady state it means that at any given point of time if we have reached the steady state it means that the rate of dissolution is equal to the rate of crystallization. Fine. That's a steady state. Now what happens? You keep on adding more. Fine. You keep on adding more. They keep on dissolving more till you reach a point where you can add no more, where there is no more dissolution possible. Why? Because whatever additional you dissolve, exactly the same is ejected out. Okay? So what happens? You'll find that though you are stirring and stirring it at a given temperature, I'm again saying that, you keep on stirring it, and you'll find that the sugar is still kind of at the bottom, just moving round and round. Now that is the point where you will no more be able to add the solute molecules, and you said that your solution has become saturated. Okay. So, saturated solution. When at a given temperature, we are no more able to add solute to the solvent, we are said to have reached saturation point. Point, and the solution is called saturated solution. Okay, and the solution is called a saturated. We are coming to that. Okay. So what happens here? Solute plus solvent, as we have said, is a dynamic equilibrium. So it keeps on forming solution. Keeps on getting out of it. Okay. Now, what is an unsaturated solution? Obviously, the one in which more solute can be added. So, that's a no-brainer. So, unsaturated solution is the solution in which more solute can be added. At a given temperature. Fine. Now, whatever is the concentration of the solute in a saturated solution, that is called the solubility. Fine. So solubility is what? It is nothing but the concentration of a given solute in a given solvent of a given specified amount of solvent concentration of a given solute in a given specified amount of solvent is termed as solubility of the solute. Is called the solubility of that solute at that temperature. That becomes very, very important. Because I do not know whether you have done that. You keep on stirring, say a saturated solution, you are able to dissolve no more, you go and heat it. Okay? You go and heat it, what happens? You'll find that you'll be able to dissolve more of the solute into it. Fine? And it exactly happens that way, that if you put the whole thing into the refrigerator, what will happen? Solute particles will get ejected out. So whatever you had by the force of temperature you had pushed in, just by lowering that temperature, it gets ejected out. Fine? You understand?